On the 27th of May, NASA and SpaceX will launch astronauts from Cape Canaveral, Florida to the International Space Station. However, there is a long and interesting story that made this happen. Hello and welcome to my first video. I'll be making in-depth videos like this and live streaming major space and gaming related events. If you want to support small creators, do stick around. In 2004, George W. Bush, trying to replicate John F. Kennedy, proclaimed a return to the moon and then Mars with the Constellation program. It was a bold vision just after the Columbia tragedy, which finally proved the space shuttle to be unsafe for human spaceflight. More importantly, it gave a reason for astronauts to risk their lives and not just do busy work. However, the program was woefully underfunded and simply too expensive. This resulted in President Obama cancelling the program, with only Orion and the Space Launch System remaining. But the SLS wouldn't be ready until 2017. In reality, its first flight will probably be in 2021 with the Artemis program. This produced a gap after the retirement of the space shuttle in 2011, where the US had no domestic vehicle capable of launching US astronauts to space. The Commercial Crew Program is the United States human spaceflight program administered by NASA, where private vendors develop and operate crew vehicles to carry US and international astronauts to and from the International Space Station. The intent of commercial crew development was to develop safe and reliable commercial ISS crew launch capabilities to replace the Soyuz, where seats were purchased from Russia. Seats costing up to $70 million per passenger per flight. Commercial crew development followed the successful ISS cargo program with fixed price funding, differentiating from the cost plus of old. It began in 2010 as a technology and capability development program, and operational contracts to fly astronauts were awarded in September 2014 to SpaceX and Boeing. The Commercial Crew Program had four main phases. Phase 1 consisted of $50 million awarded in 2010 to five US companies to develop human spaceflight concepts and technologies. NASA awarded development funds to Blue Origin, Boeing, Paragon Space, United Launch Alliance, and SpaceX. However, NASA downselected to four companies, awarding Blue Origin with $22 million for a launch abort system, Sierra Nevada Corporation with $80 million for the Dream Chaser, SpaceX with $70 million for Dragon 2, and finally Boeing with $92.3 million for the CST-100 Starliner. In the next phase, NASA wanted proposals to be complete end-to-end for operation, including the spacecraft, launch vehicle, launch service, ground and mission operation, and recovery. NASA released a request for proposal on the 7th of February 2012 and announced the selection process 6 months later on the 3rd of August 2012. The winners were Sierra Nevada Corporation with $212.5 million for the Dream Chaser on an Atlas V, SpaceX with $440 million for a Dragon 2 on a Falcon 9, Boeing with $460 million for a CST-100 Starliner on an Atlas V. Next was the certification products and contract, which involved the development of a certification plan with engineering standards, tests and analysis, included testing and verification to allow crewed demonstrations to the International Space Station. NASA issued a request for proposal on the 19th of July 2013, and over a year later, on the 16th of September 2014, NASA announced that Boeing and SpaceX had received the contracts to provide launch services to the International Space Station. Boeing could receive $4.2 billion, while SpaceX could receive up to $2.6 billion. The first flight of the Commercial Crew Program was planned to occur in 2015, but insufficient funds caused delays. As the spacecraft entered the testing and production phase, technical issues have also caused delays. The parachute system, propulsion, and the launch abort system on both capsules. In November 2019, NASA published the first cost per seat estimate at $55 million for the SpaceX Dragon and $90 million for the Boeing Starliner, which is ironically more expensive than the Soyuz. NASA has ordered 12 operational missions to deliver astronauts to the International Space Station, 6 with each supplier. I believe that the Commercial Crew Program is an innovative template that will expedite the further commercialization of space. What an exciting decade the 2020s is going to be. So, what are your thoughts on the effects of the Commercial Crew Program? If you want more in-depth videos and found this video entertaining, please like this video and subscribe, since you might not be able to remember my username.
Thank you very much.